Yes, class, good morning. Today we'll discuss your problem solving exercise 1.3. In this exercise, two lectures have been completed. Today is the third lecture of this exercise. This exercise is an important exercise, then you solve every question of this exercise. Today I'm taking question number 8 of this exercise. Consider function f, r. What is the function here f? First question number 8 here, function f you are given, r plus, what do you mean r plus? Positive real number 2, and what is the codomain here? 4, only positive numbers, 4 to 8, this will be their open interval, and given by your fx. What will be the function here? Fx x square plus 4. So this function here means domain part only the positive real number, and 4 to infinite means codomain part only starting 4 and to infinite means only positive, the greater than 0 numbers. Greater than 0 number, it means codomain part greater than 0 numbers are here all real numbers, positive real numbers. Our function here given fx equal to x square plus 4. So what things find here? You will find here so that the f is invertible function. So first of all, you check the function. This is invertible function. This function is invertible function. And what proof that you have? With the inverse function is, and value of the inverse function means what value of the inverse function? The value of the inverse function in inverse function y equal to, you will prove that root y minus 4. This thing you will prove that here, the value of the inverse function of this. First of all, you will be check this question. This function is 1, 1 and on 2. After that, this condition is satisfied, then you will prove that the function f inverse is exist. After that, you will find the value of the f inverse of this. After that, at last, we prove that this. So first of all, starting the question according to pattern. If first we find 1, 1 on 2, then inverse is as this, then you find the value of this. So now, start the solution here. So first of all, you will be find the value of the function f 1, 1 and on 2. So now, 4. 1, 1, 4, 1, 1, get. So what value of the fx1 equal to fx2, the x square 1 plus 4 equal to x2 square plus 4, 4 will be cancelled here, x1 square plus equal to x2 square. So you can say every square number with the positive here, x1 equal to x2. You can say again x1 equal to x2. Then you can say x1 equal to x. Equating the power here, square to square, then you can say x1 equal to x2. So you can then, so f is 1, 1 function. So you can say f is 1, 1 function. After that, you will find here onto conditions. After that, you will find here value of the onto condition here. Because here x and y, both condition applied here, x and y, both x and x2 both belongs to real number. Positive real number, not or, positive real number. Because x1 equal to x2, both belong positive real numbers. After that, you will find 4 onto. 4 onto condition. What is the condition of the onto? Fx plus you will write here y. Y equal to x square plus 4. And you know what is the y is belong of the, what is the y is belong of the 4 to infinite. So this is the belongs to 4 to infinite. 4 is the using an infinite. So y is belongs to 4 to infinite, codomain part 4 to infinite, and so then what value of the x here? X equal to y minus 4. What value of the x equal कि 4 माइनस वाई, और यू नो कि वैल्यू ऑफ दी एक्स हियर ओनली पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर, तो मीन्स ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो, पॉजिटिव नंबर्स, दिस विल बी द नॉट नेगेटिव, वैल्यू ऑफ दी एक्स डिपेंड ऑन दी पॉजिटिव नंबर्स, ओनली पॉजिटिव नॉट नेगेटिव, ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो, मीन्स वैल्यू ऑफ दी 4 माइनस वाई इक्वल टू पॉजिटिव ऑफ दी, बिकॉज यार पॉजिटिव नंबर्स यार यार ऑल्सो इज पॉजिटिव, पर यार ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो 4 माइनस वाई, देन यू विल बी फाइंड यार कि व्हाट वैल्यू ऑफ दी व्हाट वैल्यू ऑफ दी एक्स यार रूट 4 माइनस वाई, तो सपोज दिस वैल्यू आर पुटिंग यार इन दिस फंक्शन, देन यू गेट दी फंक्शन ऑफ दी ऑन टू कंडीशन सेटिस्फाइड और नॉट, यस नो नोट डाउन इट फर्स्ट, देन कंडीशन यार एफ एक्स यार what value of the fx, fx here condition given ki x square plus 4, or value of the x here root 4 minus y equal to root 4 minus y square and 4 minus x square plus 4, so square root of 4 minus y square with help of this square root will be gone here plus 4, 4 to plus 4 and minus 4, 4 minus y, x square plus 4, so here x square plus 4, putting the value now, y minus, this condition, this is the wrong here, y, this is the value of the y minus 4, you will write here y minus 4, this is not 4 minus y, because square root of 4 my, y minus 4, here write y minus 4, y minus 4 and y minus 4, then you write here y minus 4, this 4 will be cancelled here, what is left here, y, because here value of the x square will be y minus 4, so the same value here y minus 4, same value here y minus 4, same value y minus 4, this is 4 to 4 cancelled, what is left here, y, so means the value of the f root y minus 4 is y. You can say ki function is onto. So therefore, f is 1 and onto. 1-1 condition is satisfied. Onto condition is satisfied. Then you can say, so f is 1-1 and onto, then f inverse is exist, then f inverse is exist, so then you will find the value of the f inverse. What things prove of the f inverse? Value of the f inverse equal to 1. So how will prove that? This the same things, value of the Gauss, value of the phi equal to y, identity function of the y, and value of the Gauss equal to identity function of the x. Suppose both the conditions are satisfied, then you can say f inverse is exist. So what value of the f inverse here? Then you define this. Just note down first, then solve next part. Yes, so this condition is satisfied, inverse is exist here, then you find the function, let I'm taking as g function of this, this codomain part are converting the domain and domain part are converting the codomain. So then the function g, then I'm taking the inverse function of the g. Okay, this g is the inverse or not here? Then we'll check this. Then define the function of gy equal to, suppose function here f, then function fy fx, here function g, then gy equal to root y minus 4. So then you will check. So how to define this function inverse or not? If the value of the Gauss x equal to identity function of the x, means you can say identity function of the identity function and phi equal to identity function of the y, means identity function of the IR. This is the R plus. And this is the Gauss equal to 4 to infinite. This is the 4 to infinite. This condition, Gauss equal to ix means anti function of the r, and phog equal to anti function of the y. So first of all, find here the gauge of x. Now first we'll find here the gauge of x. Gauge of x equal to gauge of x. What value of the fx here? The function here given, what value of the fx here? Function here given. What value of the function here? Question given here. Question function here given fx equal to x square plus 4. You will write here xg x square plus 4. Then you will be function fy. What will gy here? Gy you can write here. Y place, you will write the y place of this value, gy. You are considered sometime in the value of the y, that means gy. What value of this gy here? Square root x square plus 4 and minus 4. So this will be cancelled, 4 to 4 cancel. So what is left here? Root x square, and this will be x. So value of the gauge of x equal to x. Next, same thing, fog. Fog y equal to fog gy. Or what value of the gy here? Gy here root y minus 4. So sometime you consider this value x, fx. Sometime you consider this value x. So fx. What value of the fx here? You will put this value here, x place. Function is domain part of the fx. So you will write here fx means root y minus 4 is whole square plus 4. So what is left here? Y minus 4 plus 4. This will be cancelled as y. So this condition is satisfied. If for y value is y, and gauge of x value is x. So both the condition you are satisfied. So after that you can say the function gauge of x equal to gauge of x equal to anti function of real positive number and fog y equal to anti function of the all 4 to infinite condition. Both the conditions are satisfied. You can write here r positive, yeah, otherwise you can say x. Both thing is same. Suppose you write here y, otherwise 4 to infinite, both things are same here. So sometime write in this form, sometime write here the x form. So both the conditions are same. So then you can say if function g is the inverse of the f. Yes, note down it. You can say that it, if function gy, what value of the gy are root y minus 4 value, and the value of the g equal to f inverse y equal to root y minus 4 root. Because this is the proof, this value of the f inverse, this is the f inverse here. G and f having the g is the f inverse of the g. Yes, according to you that prove that these things. Let's note down the next part. Yes, then next question here, question number 9. Consider function f r plus r positive real number 2 minus 5 to 8 given and defined by fx is equal to 9x square plus 6x minus 5. So that f is invertible function of this. Question number same this. Question number 8 and 9 is same, but some tricks of this, different tricks of this solving question number 9. Then I will solve this question. Suppose you are directly solve this question, then this will be not solved. So first of all, what is the value of the question number 9? Solving tricks are different. Function f equal such that positive real number 2 minus 5 to real number defined by what? Defined by your function fx. Important things are function. कि 9x square plus 6x minus 5. Fx 9x square plus 6x minus 5. This is the function here. So you will check this function is invertible or not. First thing. Second thing you will check here. You will prove that here. कि value of the f inverse y. What things your value of the f inverse y equal here minus root y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3. You will be prove that these things, that this is the invertible function. Value of the inverse function of this value of the inverse function of this function. The first will check this function is 1 1 and on 2, then you will find the value of the inverse function of this value. Then now suppose what is the different things here? Suppose you will directly solve this here, okay, this is the 1 1 function, this is not true. So first of all you will making the perfect square of this. You will make the perfect square of this. How it possible is okay, 9 you will make the 3x is whole square plus 6x minus 5. Suppose you are making 3x plus 1 is the whole square. What is the 3x square? See, this one is 3x square 9 or 3 to the 6 per 1 plus 1 to minus 1 minus 5. Because suppose you are using this condition applied here, so what is the value of 3x square plus 1? This one is the extra of here and plus 6x. So 6x will be equal to 6x, 3x square equal to 3x square, but this plus 1 square is the extra here. And we are making here 1 minus 1 extra. So this plus balance of this minus 1. So according to this condition, if this plus 1 is extra in this step, so then you are putting here the minus 1. Because plus 1 minus 1 be balanced here. That means value of this condition is the same. Because here plus 1 is extra here, so then you will be balanced with the minus 1. But then you are putting a minus 1. But then you are making your perfect square. The value of the function is this, in this way. So means this quadratic equation converted in the perfect square form. But then you find the value 4, 1, 1. What is the value of the one? Fx1 equal to fx2. First of all, this function you convert in the perfect square form. How it possible? You make it perfect square. In this step, one plus 1 is extra. Then this plus 1 extra balanced by the minus 1. So then, suppose you have solved this step, the answer will become same. And this step, the value of this both step also is same. And now, the 3x1 plus 1 whole square minus 6 equal to 3x2 plus 1 is whole square minus 6. Means fx1 equal to fx2. First you write value of fx1, then here fx2. Minus 6 minus 6 both will be cancel here. So 3x1 plus 1 is whole square equal to 3x2 plus 1 is whole square. Square balance here. What is left? 3x1 plus 1 equal to 3x2 plus 1. This one also is balanced. What is left here? 3x1 equal to 3x2. 3 also is cancelled here. X1 equal to x2. So this condition is satisfied. Condition of the 1 1 is satisfied here. X1 equal to x2. Suppose you are directly putting here in this step x1 equal to x2, then your condition will be not satisfied. First of all, you will make in the perfect square. First of all, you will make it the function in the perfect square form. Then you will using the condition of the 1-1 condition. Otherwise, suppose you directly using here in this step of 1-1 condition, your condition will be not satisfied. You can check it. So now you can say okay, function f is 1-1. So f is one one function. Get it not? What is the different condition of this question here? How to find out the one one? This is the important things. Okay. Suppose directly using the in this step your one one condition, you will not get the condition. You will not satisfy the condition here. One one condition. But first of all, you will make this step in this form convert it. Means you convert in the perfect square form. Then using the condition of the one one, then your condition will be satisfied of the one one. After that, you will be find your undo condition. 4 undo. This is the 4 1 2 1 1 and this is 4 undo. What will you have the fx here? Now you check this fx here. 3x plus 1 whole square minus 6. You write a y equal 3x plus 1 is square minus 6, and then you will convert here is 6 3x minus 1 is whole square equal to y plus 6. According to this y plus 6, but then first of all you convert this form. Okay, what we do, 3x plus 1 equal to root y plus 6. After then you find the value of x here. First note down it, then we will solve next step of this question. Yes, student. So then, this is your last step here, 3x plus 1, root y plus 6. What value of the x in this step? What value of the x in this step? So the value of the 3x equal to root y plus 6 minus 1, or value of the x equal to root y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3. So this is the value of the x here. You are finding value of x in this step from here, and this is the function of the x given here. So suppose when you find the value of the onto, then you will find value of fx. Putting the value of fx means root y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3 equal 3. This value we are putting in this step, only x place in this x. Then what will you getting here? 3 outside here and root y plus 6 minus 1 minus 1 upon 3 whole square plus 3x plus 1, value of the x y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3. You will put your x place, sorry, plus 1 is whole square and minus 6 in this way. This is the x place, 3 into x plus 1 whole square minus 6 according this way. Now so you can multiply only 3 into multiply here only x. Then this 3 will be cancelled here. This 3 is a multiply out there. In this outside. What is left here? Y plus 6 minus 1 plus 1. Whole square minus 6. This one also is cancelled here. After the squaring of this, what is left? Y plus 6 is minus 6. This 6 also cancelled. What is left here? Y. The value of the fx here, y, this means this function is the onto function. So this function is the onto function. So now you can say, so f is onto function. So f is onto function because value of the fx equal to y here, then you can say here the function is onto function. So you can say that then one onto function, hence f inverse is exist. That means f inverse exists. then you find the value of the f inverse y equal to this. Then you find, means f inverse is like this. After that you can say that f inverse is like this, then value of the f inverse is equal to here. After that you will prove that these things, the value of the f inverse y equal to this. Yes, note down it.